friends, Akidearest, and happy holidays, everyone! So for the past almost 4 years, I've been celebrating Christmas here in Japan, and it kind of got me thinking to make a video on how different Christmas is in Japan in comparison to America. I put Japanese subtitles in here because I'm sure Japanese people might find it kind of interesting to see the differences between the two. I'm just gonna get into it. These are the differences and similarities of Christmas with Japan versus America. Oh my god, it's finally Christmas. I'm gonna go travel back to America. I'm gonna spend time with my family. I'm gonna spoil everyone. I'm gonna get everyone like 5 to 6 presents each. It's gonna be great. I need a girlfriend. So Christmas is the biggest holiday in America. In fact, I would argue that it's Christmas, then Thanksgiving, and then Halloween. My family usually starts prepping the day after Thanksgiving, which is the last Thursday of November. It is a very precious holiday to many, and depending on your faith or religion, it is also a very holy time of the year. Whereas in Japan, Christmas is more romantic than anything else. It's actually viewed pretty much on the same level as Valentine's Day. So because of that, there's not really need for too much of a religious meaning to it. There are religious people in Japan that celebrate Christmas, but it's not really at the forefront of what this holiday is about. I would actually argue that Christmas Eve is even bigger than Christmas Day.
Christmas is something important to a lot of people. It's a time to spend with family, friends, and of course, on your phone, when you download Goddess of Victory NIKKE! Ha! The game was globally launched in November and is the top free game in both iOS and Android in Japan, South Korea, and the US, which probably makes you wonder why it's so popular. Well, Goddess of Victory NIKKE is an immersive sci-fi RPG shooter where you recruit and command various maidens to form a beautiful anime girl squad that specializes in wielding guns and other unique sci-fi weapons. Be the hero of your own anime with the best waifus in one RPG mobile game. With Japanese-English voiceover selectable and high-quality animation, you can command and collect girls that have unique combat specialties to create your ultimate team. The game has recently come with a winter update. It includes a Christmas event, Miracle Snow, and a 14-day memory login event. The game will also be holding the NIKKE Global Creators Competition soon. There'll be new characters such as Rupee, the Winter Shopper, and Anne, the Miracle Fairy, new character skins, and event battle passes. I heard that something happened between Rupee and Anne, and it's a really touching story, but if you want to know more about it, download the game. Enjoy the first Christmas with NIKKE by downloading the game in the link in the description below. The game is holding the NIKKE Global Creators Competition, so check out the official Twitter.
Christmas in America is equivalent to New Year's in Japan.
Oh man, it's gonna be New Year's. I can't wait to go hang out with my family. I'm gonna have a big feast with them. It's gonna be great. Happy New Year, everybody. This is great. Who wants to kiss?
I need a girlfriend. There is a lot of preparation and seriousness surrounding New Year's. It is also very holy to some people. Rather than celebrated on one day, New Year's is also celebrated technically on multiple days. Whereas in America, New Year's is only celebrated on the night of December 31st. And New Year's to us is essentially what Halloween is in Shibuya. For one night, we go out, get drunk, go to a party, and you also try to find someone to kiss by midnight.
Did you just say kiss?
Yes, we kiss at midnight, and no, it's not just an innocent peck on the cheek. It is a full-blown lip exchange that happens at midnight.
Oh yeah, like couples, right?
No. It could be a friend, it could be a stranger. Whoever it is, just know that if someone does ask you to kiss them, keep in mind that this is a thing that we do.
Every year, it's the same thing! I never get to kiss anyone! I hate New Year's!
Rach, listen, I'm gonna kiss you at midnight.
What?
Boy, everyone's gotta kiss someone. Can't kiss Ross, you got the history.
3, 2, 1!
But there is no rule saying that you have to do it. If you don't want to, you can just straight up say no. You can just say, nah, I don't feel like it, it's fine. And we would take it okay.
And then once the new year starts, we pretty much go back to normal. But going back to Christmas, these are some differences that I've noticed.
I'll get fruitcake, ham, chicken, and mashed potatoes. Yeah, that sounds good, and if I cook with everyone, it'll be even more special.
Honey, don't forget to pick up the KFC! And bring back a cake!
So in America, when you think of Christmas food, you think of a feast with your family because most restaurants and shops are closed on that day. Whereas in Japan, there are two things that are very popular here. Number one is getting a Christmas cake, and these are really pretty. And if you really want a good one, you usually have to book a cake weeks in advance before Christmas. The other type of cuisine is KFC, Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Christmas.
パーティーバーレル早割り9日までネット予約も
クリスマスケンタッキーにしない？
クリスマスが今年もやってくる。
今年は誰とどう過ごす？クリスマスパック予約受付中ネット予約もクリスマス
ケンタッキーにしない？
There's a literal lines of people booking to pick up their chicken on Christmas. There is nothing in particularly different about the flavor and the way that they cook things. I think it was just a very good marketing tactic that was started in like the 70s. And somehow it caught on and now it's this thing that Japanese people love to do during Christmas. KFC. Another thing that's different is illuminations.
Oh honey, let's go to this illumination. It looks really pretty. We can even bring some of our friends if you want. Oh yeah, that's a great idea. Honey, go out and get me more Christmas lights. Well, again, why?
Because those assholes living next door are brighter than us. And we should have the brighter house because we're better than them, and that's what Christmas is all about. Our house is like a fucking light bulb next to theirs. You think Santa's gonna see our dimlit house next to theirs? No! He's gonna see them, and he's gonna go right past us because he didn't fucking spot us. So we gotta get more Christmas lights.
He's not gonna skip us.
Yeah, he will. He's just gonna be like, oh, look at this fucking house. They're not taking Christmas seriously at all. Look at their neighbors. They're shining brighter. Yeah, fuck them. I'm gonna give them any presents.
Honey, you've been good all year. It's fine.
Yeah, and it's all gonna go in vain because of your weak-ass fairy lights everywhere. Fuck your Instagram.
Japan's illumination events are spectacular. You will see posters all around Japan as Christmas comes up of different illumination events that you can go to. I don't even know how long it takes to plan some of these, but they are great to go to. Christmas is very romantic in Japan, so an illumination event is a really great place to go on a date to. America does have illumination events, but I don't think that they are nearly as immaculate as Japan's. Instead, our illumination events are at our front door. We take our housing decorations very seriously when it comes to Christmas. There's pretty much no limit to how you can decorate your house or how much lights you can have. As long as it's on your property and you're paying the electric bill, it's totally fine. And in case you're wondering, this is not something that bothers the neighbors. It is actually praised that the more lights you have, the better. Another thing is presents.
Here you go, honey. I gave you a present. Aw, thank you. Oh, this is really great. Beautiful. Thank you so much. Okay, honey. Open up your gift.
It's a fucking subscription to Akidearest OnlyFans!
So, in Japan, it's typical to give at least one or two presents to someone that you care about because Japan has a very big gift-giving culture. Giving a gift is the highest form of gratitude that you can do in this country, so it's very important that when someone gives you a gift that you treat that gift with respect. That includes the packaging and how you open it in front of them. Whereas in America, it's actually a little different. And when you get the gift, it's a thing to rip it as fast and as violently as possible. Don't get me wrong, packaging is important to us. If you're in a group of people, it's not uncommon to do a countdown for everyone to open their gifts at the same time. And when that happens, everyone, kids and adults, are ripping it as fast as possible. I don't do this with every gift. If I see a Louis Vuitton under the Christmas tree, I'm probably not going to rip that. One thing that America and Japan does have in common is Santa. He exists. If you go to a mall during the Christmas time in either country, you will see a Santa there. You will see a line of kids that want to take pictures. I remember when I was a kid and I sat on Santa's lap and I asked for two things. A fire truck and a water gun, and I never got it, and I've resented him ever since. I don't believe Japan has the same story about Santa like America does. So in America, the story behind Santa is that if you've been a good kid, he comes to your house, goes down your chimney, and he leaves you presents. And if you've been a bad kid, then he gives you a block of coal. We also believe that Santa's favorite food is cookies and milk, so it's a thing for parents to get with their kids and bake cookies and leave it out for Santa to eat. When I was little, we did leave milk and cookies on the table, and the next morning I was so surprised to see that it was gone. I distinctly remember the empty glass of milk smelling like beer at the time, and I never questioned it. I remember that I was a good kid and I never got that fire truck from Santa, but then I thought maybe it's because we didn't have a chimney, because I lived in a desert. Why would I need a chimney? If you ask me which Christmas I prefer, Japan or America, it's kind of difficult because they're different in their own ways and it's kind of hard to compare. But I can say that a good Christmas for me would be to bring my family in Japan to celebrate Christmas so that they can see how different it is here and embrace it just like I have. So Merry Christmas, everybody! Happy Holidays! If you guys have any other fun facts about Christmas in your country, feel free to leave them in the comment section down below. But I appreciate you guys for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more content, and I will see you guys in the next video! I talked a lot. My throat is dry. Bye!